having spent time with the client to really understand their needs, it's time to go deeper and make our designs appeal to the most important audience of all, the client's customer. Start by searching Customer Journey Map in Canva. Let's use this one. This two-page document will help us consider the client's audience. The first page is about a specific potential customer called a persona. Along the top, you'll notice some instructions. These will keep you on track. Personas enable the designer to empathize with the client's customers. By understanding the audience, the designer can create solutions to address their specific needs. If this photo doesn't represent your audience, go and find one that does. There, that's more like it. Let's give them a name as well, so we really feel like we can get to know them. Describe the persona's key attributes. An attribute is defined as a quality or characteristic of a person. They can be positive or negative attributes. Don't overthink this. Just put in a few labels that will describe this audience. Any insights gained from research and client discussions will come in handy here. In the short description, you could further explain who they are. What are their demographics? What are their interests? What motivates them? Describe the persona's needs and challenges. A need is a necessity, things that must be met in order for the customer to be happy. Challenges are blockers. What's getting in the way for this persona? What's stopping them from meeting their needs? Finally, we can identify opportunities for the client to make themselves more appealing to this specific customer. There, now we are understanding the persona a lot more. When a customer interacts with a business, they take a journey. The customer journey map visualizes each specific step in the customer journey. They become aware of the business. Their interest grows and they consider the business's products or services. They take action to purchase. Begin using the product or service. Ideally, go on to repurchase or recommend the business to others. Sometimes, this is referred to as a purchasing or sales funnel. A successful journey is one where the customer moves seamlessly from one stage to the next. Touchpoints might be digital, like a website or advertisement, or physical, like a poster or signage. It's a point of interaction between the business and the persona. Understanding these moments means the designer can provide the right information at the right time. Are there any blocks as the customer moves along their journey? Do they experience moments of frustration? These are called pain points. Pain points stop the customer moving from one part of the journey to the next. For example, having clicked on an ad, the customer arrives at the client's website. Perhaps they read about the product, but don't understand how to purchase the product, and they leave the website. This is a serious problem. In the emotions row, move the dots up or down to reflect the persona's emotional experience at this point. These visuals will make it very clear where some work is needed. Finally, consider opportunities to improve the experience of the persona. Brainstorm solutions in the final row. The ultimate goal is to create a seamless customer journey with no pain points. Of course, a client's audience will be made up of different types of people, and different personas will introduce new observations. Develop more personas and customer maps to cover off the client's key customer types. Processes like this and the insights gained are so valuable when designing for clients. Discuss the findings with the client. Once all personas and journeys have been explored, it's time to move on to the next stage.